Welcome back to the Lips Reacts channel. I'm Lips, and today we continue our Game of Thrones journey with Season 2, Episode 8. This episode is titled The Prince of Winterfell. I just want to start off this video and saying an extreme thank you for spending your time enjoying and... I want to take a quick moment to say thank you for everyone who has been enjoying this series with me from the start, or jumping in, or coming over to Patreon, or popping into the comments and supporting me in whatever way you have been called to or have been wanting to. And for especially like coming over to Twitch and other social media channels, it means the world to me. This has been when I first started doing reactions on my gaming channel, when I first started doing reactions on my other channel, I had many requests for Game of Thrones, and I never thought I would start it. I thought the journey would be too grand, and I didn't know if I would enjoy it. And who knows, maybe at a different time in my life, it wouldn't have been the right show for me to watch, or it wouldn't have been the right time for me to do this. But as I am sitting here today, I have truly enjoyed my time watching Game of Thrones. I think the world is definitely going to go down in history as one of my favorites. As heartbreaking as this show can be, and truthfully, we haven't even had that much heartbreak, I don't think, yet. Unless the end of last episode was real. In which case, I'm still in denial. I haven't gotten to that yet. But it's... the show, I think it's actually the lows that pull me into this show so much. The evils and the bads and the consequences, and that makes every episode very exciting to turn back on. And I'm sure there's some sort of like psychological or brain chemistry thing that's happening there, right? Like, you're feeding this storyline, you're probably increasing adrenaline and whatever, and then there's a payoff, or maybe there's not a payoff, or maybe you're feeling anger. I've never had a show that I enjoyed being so angry in, and anger is not a feeling that I enjoy feeling, but I feel like this is a really healthy outlet to experience anger and to feel the feeling of anger without it actually impacting my life or actually being something I'm angry about. I just want to say thank you. It wouldn't be as much fun if it wasn't so fun to experience it with you all. So I'm always really, really excited to jump into the comments and chat about some of the things and kind of experience the highs and the lows with you all. So thank you for being there with me through the highs and the lows of Game of Thrones. We have much more of our adventures still left. We are just on Season 2, Episode 8. So as we wrap down Season 2, Season 1's Episode 6 through 10 of Season 1 really just, I feel like, one episode would punch you with a bat and the next episode would get your other cheek, and maybe some of the episodes hit you twice emotionally. And I kind of feel like we're getting to a similar place with this. Last episode, the ending was shattering, and I'm of one mind going in, right? One mind is that it was kind of a cliffhanger on a purpose, and not as much bad happened that we think did. Now, the last time I thought that an episode had a cliffhanger and we weren't going to wake up in the next episode to the horrible thing we thought we saw was Ned Stark's death. So the other side of me is very much going in thinking maybe Bran and Rickon. Those the two. I know Bran is the second youngest Stark. Maybe the two youngest Stark really are dead. Maybe they really were burned by Theon. Maybe Lady Stark will and Jaime Lannister. And now, while that's not necessarily the ending of Jaime Lannister's life, is not something that I don't want. Jaime Lannister is an aggravating character. He's written very well. He's acted so well. And also, just as a side note, if I ever say anything negative about a character, it's not about the actor. So the actress who plays Cersei, the actor who plays Joffrey, the actor who plays Jaime Lannister, they are all doing a phenomenal job because they are making me feel angry. And that's good on them. Phenomenal on them. So I think there's a lot of political dominoes that fall in a negative way for the people that I do have affinity for if Lady Stark kills Jaime. So that's where we're starting this episode. And of course, Jon Snow is in a big predicament right now. If you want to watch the full-length reaction along with me, you need your own copy. And you get more thoughts, more insight into each moment of the show, and it's phenomenal. So thank you everyone that is over there watching them with me. It's also a really phenomenal way to help support me and make this a more viable income source, which allows me to eventually someday bring on an editor that allows me to create better, high quality content, better and more content, and improve the quality of what I'm able to put out. So just that is something that helps. While I have your attention, don't forget to hit like and subscribe on this video. Grab yourself a snack, grab yourself a beverage, your favorite blanket, and I'll see you in the show. Oh, that is a way to start. Those are all the messenger birds. His sister's here. She loves to intimidate him, and I love her for that.
I saw the bodies above your gates. Which one gave you the tougher fight, the cripple or the six-year-old?
She's not wrong.
You treated them with honor by butchering them. Before-
Say it louder.
You know how valuable those boys were.
If I hadn't killed them, the Northerners would think me weak.
You are weak. And you're stupid.
She's not wrong. He is weak. Well, I mean, he exhibits characteristics that seem that are weak.
I've taken Winterfell. And I will keep Winterfell.
Not for long, I hope.
We both loved our mother. We both endured our father.
That tells us a lot about what we need to know about their home life.
Don't die so far from the sea.
Ooh. She said, come home. Come home, baby bro. He was grasping for a way to make his family proud, and somehow he didn't even do that.
Knows all about where the Krolls are and what they're planning.
The Half-Hand knows more. This one's just a little boy. Got him.
He could have killed me half a dozen times.
And now he wishes he did.
Yeah, he does.
But he's a bastard of Winterfell, Ned Stark's son.
That got his attention.
He runs. I'll chop his balls off.
I do not doubt that.
Didn't do it. I had the sword in her neck, I just...
I know. When you didn't come back, we weren't looking for you.
He got...
You found your tracks fast enough. But they found us before we found you.
Well, clearly.
You died because of me. See that it wasn't for nothing.
And you're marrying her for a bridge.
An important bridge. Oh. It was before they killed my father. I still thought I could march south and rescue him.
And then his father died anyway.
He was the best man I ever met. I know children always think that about their fathers, but he truly...
Children do not always think that about their fathers.
Ooh, she doesn't think that about hers.
He once told me that being a lord is like being a father. Except you have thousands of children, and you worry about all of them.
That was one of the good ones.
He told me he woke with fear in the morning and went to bed with fear in the night.
What a nice leisurely stroll when the world is absolutely crumbling around us.
I want the men following me to go home.
And why don't you?
Because we'll never be safe until the Lannisters are defeated.
And his sisters.
And because I believe in justice.
And your sisters.
The Kingslayer. He escaped in the night. How?
Jaime escaped again? She let him go.
Tell me this.
She didn't kill
true.
Him, she let him go.
For the girls.
You betrayed me.
Robert.
No!
Bran and Rickon are captives in Winterfell. Sansa and Arya are captives in King's Landing.
I lost another to the Kingslayer, strangled with a chain. You commit treason because your children are prisoners.
I grieve for your sons, my lord.
I don't want your grief. I want my vengeance.
Vengeance. Vengeance. Is it justice or is it vengeance?
So I would not buy life for your children. But returning him to King's Landing may buy life for mine.
Jaime Lannister has played you for a fool. You've weakened our position.
Maybe it was his plan all along. He did kill that boy to get out.
Make sure she's guarded day and night.
Rob!
How many men did we send in pursuit
of the Kingslayer?
Probably
knew he would.
40, Your Grace.
I mean, there's no way he would have known.
Rob!
All of that. Why did you do it? Why did you do it? I mean, I know why she did it. To save. Wow.
You're much happier in daylight.
Oh my god, she sent Brienne out with him. Oh, she didn't just let him go free. Okay. I'm listening. Catelyn Stark has possibly never led us astray.
Innocent.
Has anyone ever told you you're as boring as you are ugly?
You will not provoke me.
Low blow.
All my life, men like you've sneered at me. And all my life, I've been knocking men like you into the dust.
If you're so confident, unlock my chains.
No.
The Greyjoys have done us a great favor. Stark won't risk marching on Casterly Rock until he's at full force.
He's a boy and he's never lost a battle.
Sly, I appreciate Tywin.
Because he doesn't know enough to be afraid.
Tywin doesn't... Somehow Tywin doesn't rule with his ego?
We'll ride at nightfall.
Oh.
The girl's proven herself a good servant. She'll stay on with you.
Sorry, Arya. Uh-oh. She going to give the third name?
Yoren's little cunt. Used to be a boy, now it's a girl.
Disgusting and terrifying.
Where's your stick,
Arya?
Bitch?
Get out of there.
Lord Tywin's marching tonight.
You need him.
He's helping me.
Arya keeps so much close to her chest.
Where?
It's
so
smart.
They were rushing out the gates a few hours ago.
For being as young as she is, it's so smart. Who does she want him to kill? Was it Tywin?
They'll never trust me. They might. If you do what needs to be done.
What? How does it feel knowing those men all died?
He's gonna save Jon's life. If the crows don't want him, if the Night's Watch doesn't want him, then the White Walkers can have him. Gave him a clean break.
Why am I here?
To help me plan the defense of King's Landing. Stannis will be here any day.
And one of these explains how to beat him. I'd swap all your books for a few good archers. My Lord Hound, Lyra.
We don't know near enough about him.
See, it's not the fighting that kills most people. It's the starving. Food's worth more than gold.
Interesting. How does he know all of this?
The thieves, they love a siege.
See, I'm saying we don't know enough about him. He's very closed off.
Stannis knows King's Landing. He knows where the walls are strongest, and he knows which gates are weakest. Mudgate. A good ram will batter it down in minutes.
Thinking like someone who's been inside an interesting parallel to the Wall and the Wild Things. Wildlings?
What do we have?
Pig shit.
Where do you think John is right now?
They went off with a half hand. They didn't come back. A betting man would go with dead.
Poor Samwell.
He's a great fighter.
Well, he's better than me. And a lot better than you.
They didn't come back, obviously, so... What in the Seven Hells is that?
The first men made these marks. Help me with it.
Oh.
That's a Night's Watch cloak.
It's been here a long time.
Must be Dragonglass.
Dragon.
Holy.
How long after I give you the name does it take you to kill someone?
Depends.
That's certain. The time is not.
He's taking his army to attack my brother.
He's so purposeful. And poetic.
Jack and Hagar.
Himself? Is that
a
joke?
Gives a man his own name.
That's right. I'm not joking. Man can go kill himself. I'll unname you.
Thank you.
If you help me and my friends escape.
This would require more than one life. This is not part of our bargain.
Fine. Jack and Hagar.
Wow, the leverage.
The girl and her friends will walk through the gate at midnight.
Smart girl.
Odd little boy.
I have a certain sympathy for odd little boys.
You and Varys both.
Ew. Cersei, you know it's not like that. You have an odd thing for your siblings and relatives.
He's not ready.
What is he? 17? Remember Jaime at 17?
Better than you. Some men have a gift for this sort of thing.
Why do I have respect for Cersei?
You've shipped off my only daughter. Now you want to send my eldest son to the battlefield to die.
Like, I disagree with everything she does, but I can understand her motives.
Do you know why Varys is so dangerous? Because he doesn't have a cock. You, on the other hand, are as big a fool as every other man.
Ooh, shit.
Why are you smiling?
Because I have your little whore. Tell me, have you married this one yet? No?
Why is she so... Never mind. Whatever little piece of sympathy or empathy or positive feeling I was thinking about Cersei, it's gone.
Pretty thing, your whore. The bruises will heal in time.
What the hell?
Really, a Lannister lion necklace. You need to hide your secret whores more carefully.
Did he give her a necklace?
You like her very much.
And she did say she wanted him to love something and then lose it.
And if he dies, there isn't a man alive who could devise a more painful death for your little cunt.
Self-centered. Is that what it is?
Mandon, bring in my brother's whore.
Please, it's not her. It's not her. Fuck. But she has been beaten.
I promise I will free you.
Don't forget me.
She played into it. He paid her. He rented her. Cersei's weak point is showing.
A day will come when you think you're safe and happy, and your joy will turn to ashes in your mouth.
That is the most intense, evocative threat. Your joy will turn to ash. He didn't actually threaten her.
Jay!
What is wrong?
He was so worried. He was so worried.
We have to be more careful.
Don't be afraid. I can take care of myself.
No, you don't understand.
I would kill for you. You know that. I expect I'll have to before this is over.
Interesting. Oh my god.
Any Ironborn who surrender will be allowed to return safely to their homes.
Much.
Any Ironborn with the exception of Theon Greyjoy.
Ooh.
Betrayed our cause. He betrayed me.
That anger in him. It hurts more because he was so close.
Your pardon, my lord.
Vengeance. It's vengeance instead of... No, maybe this is justice.
How am I? The man I considered my closest friend has seized my home and my brothers.
It was a stupid question.
No. Oh.
You're being kind. I have no rights.
We have every right.
That's not the kind of king I want to be.
Oh, shit.
What kind do you want to be?
That's my king.
The good kind?
Who's gonna tell him?
Kings grew up as princes. They spend their whole lives preparing for the crown.
I was raised to be a proper little lady. To play the harp.
I'd like to hear you play the harp.
No, you would not.
She's literally saying, I was raised to do these things and I didn't like them. Mr. Rob. Lord. King.
Every child in Volantis was in the ruin that day. I was treading water when I realized I hadn't seen my brother. And then I saw him floating face down.
She was young.
He was so little.
Did she get blamed for it?
And he was dead. A man ran over. He had a fish tattoo on his face. In Volantis, the slaves have tattoos. So.
Did he save her brother?
And he started pressing on my brother's chest until my brother spat out half of the roid.
Oh, good God.
I decided two things that day. I would not waste my years planning dances and masquerades with the other noble ladies.
She would become a healer.
I would never live in a slave city again.
That taught her so much about how people matter outside of their class.
I blathered on.
I don't want to marry the Frey girl.
Oh.
I don't want you to marry her.
I want them to marry each other. They would be so good.
I hope it's a very beautiful bridge.
They would be so good together. They have such beautiful hearts.
You trusted him to fight with us and you set him free and he ran. I want to go back to the kitchens.
Shut up.
Oh. She risked a lot to get you guys out. Oh shit, why is she doing that? Oh, wait, I guess he said you and your friends will walk out at midnight. Did he have to kill them? Their fate. Nope, he killed people. Okay. Let's... Nope, they are fake? Killed? You know what? I don't have a lot of questions. Let's run.
Well, I held Storm's End with 500 men.
No one has forgotten your grace.
No, Robert did. He gave Storm's End to Renly after the war.
He was only a boy.
So why'd he give him Storm's End?
Why did he?
We couldn't feed them, so fine, the horses. And the night before you slipped through, I thought my wife was dying. Slipped right through in your little black sail boat with your onions.
Preyed on how hungry they were.
Robert told me to hold Storm's End, so I held it. Then he told me he was giving it to Renly. So I gave it up.
Did everything Robert told him to do.
But now I'm the rightful king by every law of Westeros.
Look, even Ned agreed with that.
The Stark forces are distracted. Now is the time to strike. They say Stannis never smiles. I'll give him a red smile.
Young idiot.
My brother was the youngest king's guard in history. My sister
Game of
became
information.
Queen at the age of 19. My father put me in charge of all the drains and cisterns in Casterly Rock.
Wow.
John Arryn and Ned Stark were good men, but they disdained the game and those who played.
And he doesn't. Tyrion doesn't.
If Stannis breaches the gates, the game is over.
Oh, you know who else plays the game? Tywin. Shame. Tywin doesn't respect Tyrion more.
We cannot stay here.
They have my dragons. Mother does not flee without her children.
They're not your children.
She is the mother of dragons.
And I know you love them, but you didn't grow them in your womb.
Did you not see her walk into the fire?
They are my children. And they are the only children I will ever have.
I think he might love her.
I'd leave him up a few more days.
They haven't got the damn message yet. A few more days won't help.
Whoever those poor kids are.
He's feeding the crops now.
They are. They're downstairs. The only way to outrun them was to stay right under their nose.
Got as far as the farm, then double back.
Yes. You can't
march
outrun them.
The stream to throw off the hounds.
Yep.
Thought this would be the last place they'd think to look.
Did he come
You're
down?
Right.
He sure did.
Bran would blame himself.
They'll never hear it from me.
Except he's hearing it right now. Poor baby. He's so young. He's just a baby. He's just a baby. He's just a little lad. Fuck. For an episode with very little fighting, there was a lot of movement and a lot of things to discuss in terms of big arcs of what's happening. One of the very early on comments that I made was that I called Theon weak. And I kind of want to dive into this perceived strength versus weakness thing, because I think I'm always trying to say things that get around this sentiment a lot, and they come out weird in the speed of trying to get my thoughts out. Now, to me, when I look at the players on our board, the higher up lords, kings, leaders, etc., people who stand out to me as the stronger characters are the, like, Tywin, strong leader, okay? Cersei has a lot of strong opinions, but where she falters, it's because she makes these self-centered decisions. That's the only word I can find for it right now, and maybe that word will evolve. There's another like layer to this that we'll get to. Theon is like a weak leader, and then you see his sister. Theon's a weak leader because he's like fighting, he's trying to prove himself in these really hasty ways, and he's not really thinking things through, which is a really, truly a lot of time to think, no. And maybe it's like, there's like this ego in it. I mean, Theon was like fighting for this perceived power, which Cersei, I feel like, is doing as well, except for she does have power. But there's something in her that always feels like, there's something in her that comes across crassly, and maybe it's that self-centeredness. It's like she doesn't, if it doesn't help her, it's not for her. If it doesn't impact her life negatively, it doesn't matter. If it does impact her life negatively, she will absolutely beat a sex worker. But like, if she has leverage, she will keep Sansa safe. But she wants her son to have a child, so she's going to coach Sansa. Like, it's this weird, like, allowing... She was afraid for her own daughter to leave, but then is, like, also simultaneously coaching Sansa to be this perfect, pretty wife for her really terrible son, who she knows is really horrendous, Joffrey. Right? So there's this weird parallel of what's happening there, and I think that's what it is. It's kind of this like self-centeredness that really grinds my gears. So I think when I'm saying that Theon is weak, it's like I can respect, like, because I can respect Tywin, like, hands down can respect her. And I Cersei almost had me there for a minute today, because, like, I understand her motives. And then she had someone beaten, and I was like, never mind. But also, can we have another moment for Tyrion's "your joy will taste like ash" line, because I'm still gobsmacked by that one. So there's this, like, there's these leaders that hold this power, steady power, and then there's these leaders or that feel a little weaker to me, like they're trying to prove something. And isn't everyone, right? So I just feel like that's kind of like a cheap shot at them. Because, like, Rob is trying to prove something. He's trying to prove something to himself, sure. He's trying to make his dad proud. He's trying to make his mom proud. He's, I don't know, he has this line of people, everyone has their own different line of honor. And that's natural. That's human nature. Okay. But something that kind of came up in today's episode is this idea of, like, justice and vengeance. Those are the two words I'll use for now. For this discussion. And it's like, what are Rob's motives that are out of, like, getting justice, and what are out of getting vengeance? And you see it where, like, when he discusses getting revenge or justice or acting with vengeance for his father's death, he's pretty level-headed about it. He's angry about it, and we saw him have a breakdown about it. But his anger for Theon was so palpable. And obviously, like, it's got to be a little more emotional because those are, like, two baby innocent kids, right? But it's the fact that Theon was his best friend, a confidant, a family member, someone he trusted deeply. And the fact that he would think that Theon would do that. And we know that Theon didn't. We officially know that Theon didn't. But to imagine that. Well, one, your best friend takes over your home. And then kills your brothers. And would Theon have actually killed his brothers if he'd actually found them? I think he would have. At least in that moment. I think he would have. And I think that conversation with his sister was really interesting. I think she nailed a lot of what I was feeling on the head of, like, are you dumb? Why would you do that? This isn't even what we're fighting for. This isn't even worth it. And all this time, I think Theon thought, I'll make my dad proud. I'll be... my family, I'll be able to be a Greyjoy again if I do this. Lo and behold, that's not really how it works, huh? It's not really how you gain respect. Respect, that's kind of it. It's like this level of respect that I have. Because, again, with Tywin, I can respect Tywin's decisions. They're strategic, they're thought out, there he's somewhat humble about them. He recognizes that he can't just walk in and win. He has to have a strategy, and I feel like that's, like, the opposite. Like, Cersei's like, well, this is ours. She feels this, like, undue ownership of it. And that's also, I think, you know what, that kind of comes down with lineage too, because Rob talks about it near the end of it, where he's like, most kings are born lords and they spend their whole life learning how to be a king. Or they're born princes, rather. And he was born to be Lord of Winterfell. And so he takes on this idea of king in a less, like, I deserve this because I was born into it. I deserve this because obviously it's my rightful. I'm the heir. I'm the rightful person for this. But he has this different code of conduct, this different honor, this different work ethic when it comes to that. And there's just so many layers to it. It's really hard to explain how it's all kind of coming through. But yeah, the themes of justice and vengeance, are they different? Whereas the lines are so blurred for me, I think they are different. Vengeance seems more hasty, more less strategic, more emotional. And justice seems a little more strategic and, like, actions, the consequence of an action. I don't know. A lot of thoughts about power and leadership in this one, and kind of where those weak spots for each person are, because everyone has a weak spot, no matter how calm, cool, collected I think they are or I perceive them to be. Every single one has a weak spot. Like, we see for some of the women in the show, we see that it's their children, and it manifests in different ways, of course. We see for some it's their fathers, it's love, it's pride, it's joy, everyone has a little something that motivates them, but also everyone has something that motivation is actually a weak spot. And if someone can find the right angle, if someone can find the right strategy, my God, can they tumble an entire person. If Cersei would have actually captured Tyrion's girlfriend, I guess. Forgive me, I've forgotten her name. Oh my God. That, I don't even want to know what would have happened if that would have really happened. It would have been brutal. We would have seen a different side of Tyrion, which honestly, it kind of almost would like to see. Especially now, like, realizing that he is playing this game. He knows he's playing this game. He's playing this game very, very well. And I think that's really interesting when I reflect on it, because he just has this different moral code, and he's easier to respect. Of all the Lannisters, he's very easy to respect, but Tywin's fairly easy to respect. But Cersei and Jaime are not. Joffrey is not. So those are my thoughts. That was kind of a lot of them. Or it felt like. So maybe it wasn't. Thank you for joining me for episode 8. We have 2 more episodes for season 2. And I have no doubts that they are going to absolutely knock us on our derrieres. And then we're going to move into season 3. But, you know, one episode at a time. One episode at a time, babe. As always, full-length reactions are over on Patreon. You need your own copy to watch along, but would love to have you over there. And otherwise, would love to have you hit like on this video if you enjoyed it. Subscribe to the channel so you get turn on notifications so you know when I post a new video. Otherwise, I'll see you down in the comments. There's also a link. There's a list of links down below of other places that you can find me, other ways that you can support me. It is my goal to, at some point this year, get an editor. I don't necessarily know if I would outsource Game of Thrones editing. The editing for Game of Thrones is incredibly helpful. Even though I'm 6 episodes ahead at minimum on Patreon for full length, the editing is still, like, rewatching it in such like a mindful manner again is incredibly helpful for catching new things and getting a little bit deeper into the world. But there's other full length content up in Patreon that I haven't been able to edit yet because I've been focusing more on the TV shows and stuff that I'm getting out over here. So it's my goal, and there's lots of different ways down below that you can help me. There's an entire throne wish list of different items that I'm trying to buy to improve my setup this year. So different ways. But just know that there's always the free ways, and those free ways of supporting me mean so much as well. But just wanted to let you guys know that those are there if you are interested in helping me evolve in a lot of different ways. Would love to have that support. Otherwise, your like, your comments, your following on other social channels. Heck, if you made it to this part of the video, you're a real one anyway. So thank you for that. And I appreciate you all so much. Really, truly, deeply. The joy in the community and the comments and the, like, just experiencing the show together has elevated it for me, and it has been such a joy. I know I've kind of slapped the wrist a few times with some things, but that's just me making sure that it stays enjoyable for me to show up, so that I can record with a light heart versus a dreadful heart, if that makes sense. So have a good one. I'll see you in the next one.